The Fa-18 Hornet, manufactured and designed by McDonnell Douglas, which is now a part of Boeing and Northrop. This is a twin-engine supersonic all-weather carrier-capable, multirole combat jet designed as both a fighter and attack aircraft. Because of its avionics, cockpit displays, and excellent aerodynamic characteristics, the Fa-18 was designed to be a highly versatile aircraft capable of carrying a wide range of weapons. There are many variants of the Fa Hornet, and today we'll list out all of them. The Fa-18A Hornet. This is the original single-seat version of the Fa-18 Hornet. On September 13, 1978, McDonnell Douglas unveiled the first Fa-18A, which flew for the first time on November 18, 1978, and entered service in 1983. For the first time in 1986, the Fa-18A Hornet was used in an airstrike against Libya. The double AR-50 and the Nighthawk pods located nearby the aircraft intakes enables the Fa-18A Hornet all-weather navigation and guided precision weapons delivery. This fighter also took part in Operation Southern Watch and over Bosnia and Kosovo in 1990s. Fa-18B Hornet. The Fa-18B has a space for the two-seat cockpit provided by a relocation of avionics equipment and a 6% reduction in internal fuel. It achieved operational capability in 1983 and retains full capability from air-to-air and air-to-surface missions. This aircraft has been ordered by the U.S. Navy and USMC, as well as by the Air Forces operating the Fa-18A aircraft. The B model is used primarily for training. Fa-18C Hornet. The Fa-18C Hornet is a more advanced version of the Fa-18A, with provisions for using advanced missiles and jamming devices. Improved night attack capability, more powerful engines, and a new radar are all included in the C model. Some of these features were introduced in late production Fa-18C or D aircraft. In low visibility situations, the pilot can use a synthetic aperture ground mapping radar to locate the targets. Production of the C model ended in 2000, and the last operational deployment of the Fa-18C Hornet in U.S. Navy service was aboard the USS Carl Vinson and ended on 12th March 2018. Fa-18D Hornet. The Fa-18D Hornet is an improved model of the twin-seat Fa-18B, incorporating provisions for employing updated missions and jamming devices. D model delivered since 1989 also have improved night attack capabilities, consisting of the hugest AAAR-50 thermal navigation pod, forward-looking infrared array targeting pod, night vision goggles, and two full-color multifunction display and a color moving map. The last Fa-18D was delivered to the U.S. Marine Corps in August 2000. Fa-18E Super Hornet. The E model is a single-seat variant which first flew in 1995. Despite its designation, it is not an upgrade of the Fa-18 Hornet, but rather a new, larger airframe using the design concepts of the Hornet. The Super Hornet has a more powerful GE-F414 engines and an upgraded avionics suite. Survivability is an important feature of the Super Hornet design. Its design incorporates a combination of signature reduction, advanced electronic warfare capabilities, reduced ballistic vulnerability, use of standoff weapons, and innovative tactics that collectively enhance the safety of the fighter and crew in an affordable manner. Fa-18F Super Hornet. Both the E and F models are the same, but the main difference is just that the E model is a single seat, while the F model is a two-seat variant. Initial production on the Fa-18E and F models began in 1995. Flight testing started in 1996, and the Fa-18EF's first carrier landing in 1997. Low-rate production began in March 1997, with full production beginning in September 1997. Like the Marine Corps' Fa-18D, the Navy's Fa-18F carries a naval flight officer as a second crew member in a weapons systems officer's role. Ea-18g Growler. The Ea-18g Growler is an electronic warfare version of the two-seat Fa-18F, which entered production in 2007. The Growler has replaced the Navy's EA-6B Prowler and carries a naval flight officer as a second crewman in an electronic warfare officer role. The Ea-18g Airborne Electronic Attack Aircraft carries up to 5 ALQ-99, 2 AIM-120C AMRAAM air-to-air missiles, 2 AGM-88 HARM missiles, and the AN-ALQ-218V2 Electronic Warfare Receiver Suite. Fa-18XT Advanced Super Hornet. The Fa-18XT Advanced Super Hornet is a 4++ generation aircraft. It is also known as the Block III Super Hornet. Its first flight test was on 5th August 2013. This new advanced Super Hornet has better network-centric warfare capabilities, allowing for exchange of large amounts of data such as target information. The Fa-18XT program was dropped in favor of the Block III Super Hornet, hence it never entered service. Fa-18E Block III Super Hornet. The U.S. Navy Block III Super Hornet is a further development of the Super Hornet. The Block III incorporates some features from the Fa-18XT Advanced Super Hornet, such as the conformal fuel tanks and the network-centric capabilities. The Block III aircraft will have a 9,000 flight-hour airframe, improved stealth coating with reduced radar cross-section, an inner fuel tank-mounted infrared search and track, and a high-rate data link. The Fa-18F Block III Super Hornet. This is the twin-seat version of the Block III Super Hornet. The U.S. Navy placed the first multi-year procurement contract for 61 Fa-18E Block III and 17 Fa-18F Block III Super Hornets on March 20, 2019. The first Block III aircraft are expected to achieve initial operating capability in 2026. Ea-18g Block III. The Ea-18g Block III electronic attack aircraft will incorporate the Super Hornet's Block III structural improvements to the Ea-18g Growler. The next-generation jammer will be installed on the aircraft, allowing it to operate in challenging environments. It will be faster to handle greater amounts of data and transfer it faster than the current Growler aircraft. Besides, conformal fuel tanks will increase the range and time on station. And with this, the Buzz is signing off for today. Thank you guys for viewing in. Bye-bye.